Hi friends, welcome to Vapa Studies YouTube channel. This is part 25 in Azure Synapse Analytics playlist. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to use identity column to create a surrogate key kind of behavior in dedicated SQL pool inside the Azure Synapse Analytics. So we will be discussing about what is surrogate key if you don't know, and also we will be discussing about the identity column in Azure Synapse SQL, and then we will try to create a table with the identity column and see how it behaves inside the Synapse. And we also see how to explicitly insert values into identity column, and also there are few limitations of using these identity columns in the Synapse. We will be discussing that as well. So firstly, let's understand what is surrogate key. Surrogate key is on a table is nothing but like it's a column which has unique identifier values for each row, right? So for example, let's assume you have a table like employee table or whatever table, and you have some rows here. So for every row, to identify each value, we can keep one ID or key kind of a column. So those columns are called as surrogate keys. Surrogate key will identify each row as a with a unique identifier value. So ID 1 will not be there for any other row. So this ID 1 will be a unique identifier for this row, and this ID 4 will be a unique identifier for this row. So like that. Okay, and this kind of behavior, it is almost like similar to identity, what you have seen in the SQL, right? I hope you guys know what is identity means in the SQL, right? If not, also don't worry, in this video we will be discussing that. So to achieve this kind of surrogate key behavior, we can use identity property inside the Azure Synapse. Like the same property will be used even in the SQL as well, right? So that is what we use. Okay, so whenever you try to create a table, so in the column definition, you can use this column should work as a identity column like that. And also you can supply like this identity column to auto increase automatically. For example, it should start with 1 and it should increase by 1. That means 1 comma 1. So if I mention here 10 comma 1, then it will start with 10 and it will increment by 1. So like that, the identity column will actually behave. Okay. So, and let's go to the next slide. So let's try to understand this identity behavior in the dedicated SQL pool. So these identity columns can be created on the tables, right? And tables will be only available on the dedicated SQL pool in the Synapse. So serverless SQL pool will not have any tables, right? So serverless SQL pool have no tables. So that means indirectly this identity will not be supported in the serverless SQL pool. Okay. So, and also in the Azure Synapse Analytics, this identity column values increases based upon the distributions actually. This line may be confusing at this moment. Don't worry, I will practically explain you this and then you will understand. Okay, let me practically show you one example actually. So let me go to SQL query window. So if you see, this is a Azure SQL database. Okay, so that means this is not a data warehouse. So here if I create any table or whatever maybe it is, it won't follow that distribution logics. So if you don't know what is distribution and all, I hope you have seen my previous videos in this Azure Synapse Analytics playlist. If you haven't seen, please watch them. And let me quickly give a rough idea like what is distribution about. If you want to know the full details, you need to see that in the previous videos of this playlist. Okay. So for example, in Azure Synapse, you will be having three types of distributions. One will be hash distribution, one will be round robin distribution, and another one will be replicated distribution. Okay, and we discussed like each distribution, how it works and all. Okay, so you need to be aware of that. So please watch my previous videos in the Azure Synapse. I think in some video I discussed about these distributions as well. Okay, so please watch them. So now let me go here and let me understand first here. So here what I am going to do, this is not my Synapse SQL database. That means this is not a data warehouse. It is a Azure SQL data server. That means it's a normal database. So here your data will store on a database normally. There won't be any distributions. Okay. So if I create a table here, if you see, this is T1 is a table name, and there are two columns called C1 and C2. And first column is a identity type, which is going to start with 1 and increment by 1. And second column is C2. Okay. And now this C1 column is identity column, right? So let me create this table and then let me insert two rows into this table. There is already one object. Okay, I think I have created some time back. So let me drop the database, drop the table. So to drop a table, you need to use drop table, then table name, right? dbo.t1. So let me drop this database first, which I created earlier. And then let me create this table freshly which has two columns called C1, C2, and C1 column is identity column. So now let me try to insert two rows into this table. So two rows are inserted here. Now let me execute select star from this table, and if you closely observe the results, your identity column is incrementing by 1, and you see your identity column behavior is continuous. It is not skipping any identity columns, and you see ID1, then ID2, then ID3, if you insert another row, ID4. So everything is in a continuous order or in sequence order. But the same identity column behavior will not be in the sequence order in the Azure Synapse case. Okay, so let me practically show you that as well. So I have connected here my Azure dedicated SQL pool endpoint here, if you see. And so this is my dedicated SQL pool data warehouse. We should not call it as a database. This is actually data warehouse. And in the data warehouse, your data will not store like a normal database. So here the data will be distributed into multiple distributions and it will be stored. Okay. So here, let's see how this identity column will actually behave. And then I will give you a rough idea how that behavior or how the distribution's logic is working. So here, if you see, I'm creating the same table called T1. Two columns, column 1, column 2, and identity column, which is starting with 1 and incrementing by 1, and column 2. And here, if you see, I am using a hash distribution, okay, and then I am trying to insert two rows, and then let's select this. So let me explain you first how this hash distribution works very quickly, and then I will execute this query and I will show you how this identity column behaves in case of dedicated SQL pool. So let me go here, let me clear this canvas here. So in hash distribution, what will happen? So let's assume this is your table. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, you have some columns. Okay, and here you have a logic decided like you want to use a hash distribution. Okay, and then let's assume, so if you have seen my previous video, you know that you will be having compute nodes, and each compute node you will be having 60 distributions. So totally in a synapse, totally the data will be distributed across 60 distributions. So each distribution is nothing but like a thick like one database or one machine where your data will be stored. Okay, so for example, this row 1 has a value of A, let's assume. So in hash distribution, let's assume this is column 1, this is column 2, this is column 3, like that. Okay, so if you in hash distribution, you need to define on which column you want to create a hash and then load the data. So let's assume you decided like hash should be on top of my column 1. Then let's assume this column 1 has a value A, right? For this A, it will create one hash, and depending upon the hash value, it will decide where this row has to go and store. That means in which distribution it has to go and store. So what it will do now? So let's assume according to this hash logic of value A, it is decided to go and store inside the distribution 1. And let's assume here you have a value B. So for this value B also, hash will be calculated and then it will decide store it in some distribution. So let's assume third row is A once again. So this is also A, this is also A, right? So the hash of these two values will be same. That means these two will get stored in same distribution only. So as per our example, the first value stored in the distribution 1. So this second value, this second value of the same, right, in the third row, this will also go and store in the same distribution. Why? Because it's the same value, that means the same hash logic, and that is the reason it will store into the same distribution as well. Okay, so that's how it works actually, hash distribution. So hash distribution will generate a hash based upon the key value on which column you are defining that, and then it will try to decide in which distribution to go and store. So in Synapse, totally you will be having 60 distributions, and all the 60 distributions your data will be stored randomly. Okay, so it will not, all data will not store at a single place, it will be stored at a 60 distributions. Okay, so now with this idea here, now if I go here, if you see, I am creating a table which has two columns. Column 1 is identity column and column 2 is a varchar of type. And if you see, I am creating a hash distribution of C2. And now if you see in the column 2 on which I created a hash distribution, I am inserting a similar value, null null, right? So since both the values are same in the two rows, these two rows will go and store in a single distribution only. So it's not like this will store in distribution 1 and this will store in distribution 3, like that it will not happen. I will practically show you that as well. So let's create this table first in the dedicated SQL pool, which is going to be a hash distribution type. Okay, our table created successfully. Let's insert two rows where the column 2 values are same. Why? Because I am using that column 2 as a hash distribution logic for me. Okay, so let's insert these two rows here. So two rows are affected. Now let's execute select star from the table and see how the identity column generated first. If you see here, now we have identity column generated differently. Here identity column value is 1. Then we will be expecting identity column value 2 here, right? But it came as 61 here. The reason is what will happen now? So let me execute this query first, database check, where I am trying to see the space used, okay, for the table 1. So let me execute this query and let's try to understand this query first. Okay. So now if you closely observe this query here, let me see here. See, totally 60 distributions I said, right, in the synapse. See, from 1 to 60. See, all the 60 distributions will be shown for your table. And if you see on the distribution 1, 2 rows stored. So far in my table I has only 2 rows. And both the rows came and landed into the distribution 1 only. Why both the rows came into the same distribution? Why not one row came here and one row maybe came in some other distribution? The reason is both the rows has a same value. And the same value, when the hash function applied on the same value, the algorithm will work as a similar thing and it will identify the same distribution to store that. Okay, so that's why two rows came here. This is first thing. Now the second thing, if I execute this select star from this table, I see in ID 1 is there for the identity column, and for the second row identity column value becomes 61. Why that is happened? The reason is what happened in middle the numbers. So what happens now if you execute this, let me execute this once again to see the distributions and all. In synapse data warehouse, the data will be distributed across the 60 distributions. What will happen now? Your system by design, it will try to reserve the identity column values throughout the 60 distributions. So when you inserted first row, that means when you inserted this first row where you got the identity column value as 1, that will be applied for the first row and it is stored in the distribution 1. And after that, for all other distributions, it will reserve, that means identity column value 3, 4. So all other identity values will be reserved for our other distributions. And when you inserted the second row also the same value, and algorithm decided that second row also has to go and store into this first distribution only. So that's why it taken identity column value as 61 here. Okay, if your second row value is different and according to the hash algorithm the second row should go into the second distribution, then you would have seen identity column value for your second row as 2. But that is not the case now. We don't know how the algorithm will be calculated and how the algorithm will decide in which distribution your row should go. So why I used the similar values in the two inserts? So that you can make sense, both the rows are coming here and the identity value for the second row should be 61, so that you can see, okay, all other identity values are distributed over the other distributions and they are reserved for them. Since my second row is not landing in any other distribution, so automatically for my row the identity column value become 61. Okay, so now what I will do, I will try to insert another row here. Let's see here. So maybe this time in the column 2 I will be passing a value as A. So this is not null, right? So this time hash algorithm should consider to take other distribution to store this value A, and the identity column value also become accordingly. For example, if this C2 value will be decided as per the algorithm to go and store in the identity call in the distribution 8, in that case my identity column value also for this row will become 8. So let me practically show you that. So let me execute this another insert, that is third row insert. Now let's try to execute this select star from and see what identity column value came for my third row. If you see, identity column value came as 8. So that means this row might have stored in the distribution 8. So let me execute this query and see that whether that is the case or not. If you see here, for the distribution 8, one row inserted. That means the third row, whatever I inserted, that is landed into the distribution 8 according to the hash algorithm, and accordingly the identity column value assigned for it. So that is the reason, if you see the slide, I have said this identity column values in the synapse are not continuous or not contiguous in the nature, that they will be not in a sequence order. You will be seeing some jumbling of the numbers, but across all your distributions no identity columns will be overlapped. So there will be no overlap. So you no need to worry. The same value what identity column assigned for another row, the same value will not be assigned for any other row. So there is no overlap. That way we are good. And yeah, so you will see this not contiguous behavior. That means your ID values are not in a sequence order kind of thing. Okay. So I hope you understood. And we have discussed, like we already discussed that, like how to create this identity column. You will be using ID identity syntax here, and you have to mention that distribution logic type and other things. Okay, so yeah, identity property does not guarantee the order, which we discussed just now, right? So because it is a data warehouse by design uses this distributed architecture, so the order of the identity property is not guaranteed. So this is the main point you should take away from this video. Okay, so anyone can ask in the interview, like in the Synapse workspace, because Synapse is a data warehouse, so how the identity column behavior will be, if it is not, whether it is in a ordered way or it is a not continuous way. If not continuous, why? You should be able to explain that. Okay, so now, so if you want to explicitly insert the identity column values, you can use this set identity insert on a table to on, and then you can supply the column value for C1 as well here, like this, right? So this is normal SQL. In SQL also you might be knowing this, right? So if you want to set the identity insert, you need to do this, the same syntax. So I'm not going to do that. You can try this. If you want to switch off this identity insert, you need to execute this command, set identity insert on a table off. So once you off the identity insert, you cannot explicitly insert the identity column values. If you have seen our example here also, if you see our insert queries, we have not supplied any value for identity column, right? So our identity column is C1, if you see, and for column C1 we have not supplied any value in any of the insert. Why? Because by default identity insert will be off for any table. If you want to explicitly enable it, you need to use this syntax, like set identity insert on a table to on, and then supply value for your C1 column as well. Okay, so let me go to the next slide. So there are a couple of limitations with identity column. You cannot use identity column if this below condition matches. Your column data set type should be int and beginit. If it is not in between int and beginit, then you cannot use identity column. And also your identity column cannot be part of your distribution key. For example, if you see this in the hash distribution here, on column 2 you cannot use the identity. Why? Because this is part of your hash distribution key, so you cannot use it. So okay, and the last limitation will be you cannot create a identity column, you cannot use on a external table. So these are the limitations where you cannot use the identity column. Okay, so if I say in reversely, you can use identity column on int and beginit data types only, and then you cannot use identity column on external tables, not possible, and also your identity column should not be part of the distribution key. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Hope you understood this video. If not, please try to watch it multiple times so that you can understand how the identity column behaves. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notifications whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.